and we'll get started. Soles of our feet together, knees out wide. Starting to move down on our backs. Allowing our knees to fall open with gravity and our shoulders to fall open with gravity as well. But before we get started, I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong to start class. Tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. and one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale, those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over your right shoulder and breathe, breathing into this simple twist, opening up your right obliques as you do, and smile again. It's Monday, it's a beautiful day out today. It's the week of our conference, so on Wednesday we start all of our installation. Thursday, everyone starts registering. It's very exciting. And then Sunday afternoon around 3:30 or so, we'll be done. Inhale back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over your left shoulder and breathe. And when it's done, I'm sure that we're going to feel like it went by way too quickly. But it's exciting that it's finally here. Again, breathing into those left obliques, releasing anything that you may have stored in your obliques. Again, and smile. It's Monday. Inhale back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. And then grab onto your insteps, drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands in happy baby. And again, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys as you do. And then from here, let's go ahead and bend your knees, cross that right leg over left, wrap your feet, eagle legs, right arm under left, wrap your arms, eagle arms. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees, crunch it out. Inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale back, exhale forward, two more, no, not yet, inhale back, exhale forward, now there's two more or seven more wherever you are, inhale back, exhale forward, inhale back, exhale forward. Again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Two more if you're with us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. And exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. And then cross that left leg over right. Wrap your feet. Left arm under right. Wrap your arms. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more or seven more, wherever you are. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. And again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale forward, inhale back, exhale forward, inhale back, exhale forward, two more if you're with us. Inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale back and exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. Rock back and forth. And then exhale those legs down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your left side. Left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale that right knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, drag that right shoulder back and down. We're in infinity pose. Maybe grab on to your calf. Drag your leg towards you as much as you can. Again, in infinity pose. Inhale, that right knee in. Exhale, down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side. Right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale, that left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Drag that left shoulder back and down. In infinity pose again. Breathing in and out. Maybe grab on to your calf muscle. Drag your leg towards you if this is in your practice. Wherever you are is perfect. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale, down to the end of the mat. Good job. Draw those knees in. Place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment as we do. We'll do three or four of these. And then arrive at the tops of our mats. In Sukhasana, simple seated pose. Good job. Crisscross applesauce. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down to the right onto that right elbow. As far as you can, reaching towards that third eye on the right side, feeling that energy coursing from your left thigh through your fingertips, opening up those left obliques, releasing toxins. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale down to the left again. Reaching towards that left wall. Feeling that energy. Coursing from your right thigh all the way through your fingertips. Again, opening up those right obliques as you do. And smile. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale as you lift that right knee. Exhale as you place it down on the mat. With the interior of your knee on the mat, up against your left foot. We're in deer pose. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down. Third eye comes down. If this is in your practice, rocking it back and forth. Opening up your intuition in deer pose. Breathing in and out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you lift that right knee, placing your right foot on your left thigh. Good job. We're in half lotus. Inhale both arms. All the way up once again.
And exhale as you fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 reach. Fingertips down, hearts come down, third eye comes down again. Maybe rocking it back and forth, opening up your intuition if this is in your practice, but don't feel like you have to. Slowly inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk them to the right, grabbing onto your right knee with your left hand. Draw that right hand back, or rock forward and take a bind, grabbing onto your right foot. Again, wherever you are is perfect. Dragging those shoulders back and down, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release that right foot. Good job. Inhale that left knee up. Exhale as you place it inside down, up against that right foot. Again, we're in deer pose. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down,
hearts come down, maybe your third eye comes down, rocking it back and forth, opening up your intuition as you do. Breathing in and out, in humbly bowing deer pose.
Walk those hands back again. Exhale as you lift your left knee, placing your left foot on your right thigh. Inhale, lotus. Again, sitting up straight, shoulders back and down. Inhale, both arms all the way up. And exhale as you fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down, third eye comes down. If this is in your practice,
again, rocking it back and forth. In humbly bowing half lotus, opening up your hips, your thighs, and your shoulders, as well as your lower backs.
Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the left. Grabbing onto your left knee with your right hand. Draw that left hand back. Possibly rock forward and take a bind. Again, inbound half lotus. Opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Breathing in and out. Good job. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release that left foot. Let's open up our shoulders now. Place your hands on your shoulders, baby bird. 10 times forward and 10 times backward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 with intention. Again, not too fast. Backward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. And then from here, place your hands on the mat in front of you and roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Inhale first again to cow. looking up towards your third eye, dragging your hearts down towards the mat. Exhale
as you bend those elbows, transitioning into cats. Gazing at your navel, dragging those spines up as much as possible.
Inhale, again, to cat, or cow, excuse me. Dragging your spines down, looking up towards your third eye.
Exhale, bending those elbows, coming into cat, gazing at our navels. One last time, inhale
to cow. Again, open up your hearts as you do, and exhale
to cat. Good job.
Come back to a flat back. Inhale your right arm all the way up. Exhale as you thread it under. Coming down onto that right shoulder again. You can either keep your left hand beside you, hips are squared to the front of the room, inhale that left arm up, bend your elbow, find your right hip crease. Again, opening up to the sidewall through the breath, in thread the needle. Again, feel your heart opening. Those shoulders should be back and down. Keep your hips as squared as possible to the front of the room in this twist. Inhale, that left arm up. Exhale, down. Inhale, that right arm all the way up. And exhale, down. Good job. Inhale, that left arm all the way up. Exhale as you thread it under. Coming down onto that left shoulder. Again, keep your hips squared to the front of the room. Inhale, that right arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that left hip crease. And again, working towards opening those shoulders to the sidewall as much as possible. I have a friend from high school who just had shoulder surgery. She was the number one seed on our tennis team while I was playing, and she was so fabulous. Inhale, that right arm up. Exhale, down. Inhale, that left arm all the way up. And exhale, down. She won every state match. I mean, she was just amazing. And I'm sure that it had something to do with her shoulder surgery. I feel so sorry for her. All of those activities that we did when we were younger are very dangerous later on. Curl your toes under, sit back on your heels. Again, making infinity symbols with our wrists. Opening up our toes and our ankles, as well as our wrists, breathing in and out. Draw those hands overhead in the Uttita. Drag your tailbones in. Again, shoulders are back and down. Maybe draw your hands behind you, fingertips touch, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Again, interlacing your fingers in Anjali Mudra behind your backs. By the way, we've been watching a series called The Mallorca Files, which is really fun. And I had a boyfriend that lived in Mallorca for the year that I was living in France and teaching at, well, the first, second, third, or whatever, third year that I was living there, teaching at the university in Montpellier. And I would go to visit him almost every weekend. And so seeing Mallorca is so much fun. It's just such a beautiful place. It kind of makes us want to retire there. But anyway, it's a fun series. It's with a British woman and a German guy who are liaisons to the Mallorcan police force, which is Catalan as well, or obviously from Spain, but Catalan. And anyway, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rock forward on your elbows. And then from here, let's go ahead and plant the palms of our hands into the mat. Curl your toes under, inhale first. Exhale as you push back into down dog, dragging your hearts towards your thighs as much as you can, flattening out your backs, lifting your tailbones up towards the heavens. Again, breathing in and out. Plant that area between your index finger and thumb into the mat as well. Take pressure off of your wrists. Keep them safe. And again, maybe walk the dog, lifting first one heel and then the other as you do, dragging the other heel down towards the mat. Good job. Inhale that right leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. And then exhale as you swing it forward to a lunge. Plant that back foot, 45 degree angle. Inhale up. Again. To Virabhadrasana 1, warrior 1. Pinky fingers are in. Gazing up at your third eye. Shoulders back and down as much as possible. And smile again. It's Monday. Exhale. Virabhadrasana 2. Now check your back foot. It should be parallel with the front of the mat. Reach, 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 palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Again, open up your obliques. Release toxins. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. And then place your hands on your hips. Left hip back, right hip forward. Good job. Float those arms out once again. Reach, 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 and burst. Again, into Trikonasana, dragging that left hip back, right hip forward. Once again. Again, triangle pose. Bend your front knee, coming into side angle. Rotate that left arm around and forward, pointing towards your third eye on the right side. Feeling that energy coursing once again. From the side of your left foot through your fingertips. Come back to center. Take a wrap. Maybe take a bind. Grab on wherever you can. If it's up towards your elbow, that's wonderful. Wringing yourselves out as much as possible. Open up once again. And again, you can either stay here or look out beyond your foot, tip yourselves, plant that right hand, lift your left leg again into Ardha Chandrasana, standing half moon. And by the way, we have a super blue moon tonight. Lots of energy coursing through everyone today. And then grab on to your foot if you'd like to in a bind. Don't feel like you have to. Maybe cup that right hand, drawing it off the mat in a balance if you'd like to. Again, Ardha Chandrasana. Release that foot. Bend your right knee. Tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. If you're still on the mat, look down. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that right leg back as high as you can. Three-legged dog split. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog.
Wherever you are is perfect. Inhale through your noses, side out, inhale.
One more time, inhale.
Good job. Inhale that left leg all the way up, three-legged dog split.
Exhale, swing it through to a lunge again. Plant that back foot, 45 degree angle. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana 1, warrior 1, good job. Again, shoulders back and down, sitting down in your warrior, fierce warrior. And again, looking up towards your third eye, shoulders back and down. Exhale, Virabhadrasana 2, check that back foot. It should be parallel with the front of the mat. Reach, 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 reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Release toxins. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Pull that right hip back, left hip forward. Float your arms back. Reach, 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 reach as far as you can, and then burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Keep pulling that right hip back, left hip forward. Bend your front knee, coming into side angle. Rotate that right arm around and forward. Into the Utthita, again, pointing towards your third eye, feeling that energy coursing from the right side of your foot all the way through your fingertips. Open up north and south, take a wrap, maybe take a bind, grab on wherever you can. Bringing yourselves out, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Open up north and south once again. Look out beyond your foot. Plant that left hand and tip yourselves. Lifting that right foot, flexing your foot to the wall. In Ardha Chandrasana, standing half moon. Again. Maybe take a bind. Possibly cup that left hand, drawing it off the mat in a balance, if this is in your practice. But don't feel like you have to. Release that right foot. Bend your left knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. If you're on the mat, look down, inhale up. To Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Hit that left leg all the way back. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Walking the dog. Good job. Inhale through your noses. Side out. Inhale. One more time, inhale. Good job. Now we're going to come up on our tippy toes, bend our knees, look towards the front of the mat, drag your tailbones in, shoulders back and down in bear pose, step or jump up, lighter than air. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. And again, dragging those shoulders back and down, looking towards the front of the room, making space. Exhale down to Uttanasana.
standing forward fold. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan neck backward. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Today we're going to do Dancer to open our hearts just a bit before this exciting weekend. So I'm going to adjust the camera. And we're going to face a wall, or if you want to, work on balance. If you're facing the wall, you can work a little bit more on opening. Wherever you are is perfect. We're in Tadasana. Before we start, make sure that you bend over and make sure that you're far enough from the wall so that you form a 90 degree angle when the palm of your hand is on the wall. Good job. Standing up. Again, in Tadasana, mountain pose. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that right tippy toe. Inhale that knee up as you flex your foot. Exhale first. Inhale that left arm up. And then exhale as you fold forward, placing that left hand on the wall. Grabbing onto your right foot with your right hand and pulling up into modified dancer. Good job. Inhale back to center. Coming into a marching position, flex your foot. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down to the mat. Good job. Shake it out. We'll do the other side, starting in Tadasana. Hands come to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that left tippy toe. Inhale, that left leg up into a marching position. Exhale first. Inhale, your right arm up above you. And exhale as you fold forward, hinge at the hips, flat backs, placing that right palm on the wall, grabbing on to your left ankle and pulling up, kicking into that hand as much as you can. Again, in dancer. Exhale as you come back to center, into a marching position. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Inhale first. And exhale down to the mat. Good job. And then from here, come up to the tops of your mats. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan back down. Inhale halfway up. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Walk that right foot all the way across. Right knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Take Venus Mudra. And exhale as you humbly bow yourselves, coming down onto that left cheek. Again, in humbly bowing. Pigeon, breathing in. And out. If you have your wrists above you, make sure that you draw them back towards your waist before you release. Again, you can either be on that left cheek, right cheek, you can be on your elbows, you can also be on your backs. Wherever you are is perfect in resting pigeon. Releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing. Breathing in and out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again, coming off on that right hip. Swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to right thigh. Bring that right foot in and your right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind in the Mariandrasana twist, wringing yourselves out, massaging your internal organs, releasing toxins. But remember to breathe. That's the way that we do this, is breathing. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Come up to the tops of your mats in Malasana or Yogi Squat. Again, backs of your biceps are just below your knees. Shoulders back and down, tailbone in. All four corners of your feet are growing into the earth. Lift your toes. Crowns of your heads are moving towards the heavens. Hands at Anjali Mudra. Either here or possibly move into Bakasana. Again, rocking back and forth, finding that sweet spot. And then rolling into Bakasana if this is in your practice. But again, since it's Monday, we don't have to. You can stay there or follow us. Inhale from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra. And exhale down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. Place your hands on the mat, inhale halfway up, again to Ardha. Take a giant step back with that left foot, walk your right foot all the way across, right knee down, left top of foot down, maybe take Venus Mudra as you walk those hands back, and then exhale as you humbly bow yourselves, coming down, whoops. Yes, this is not right, I'm sorry. We just did this. Whichever leg you just did, make sure that you do the other one. Well, actually, if we walk our left leg to the... So we should be doing our left leg right now, I'm so sorry. I have way too many things on my mind right now. Again, so we should be coming down on that right cheek, and again, either here or on our backs. You can also be on your left cheek or on your elbows. Wherever you are is perfect. Opening up that left hip. Releasing any unwanted emotions that you may be storing. Breathing in and out in resting pigeon. Slowly inhale as you walk your hands back again. Coming off on that left hip. Swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and that left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find that left hip crease or possibly take a bind in the Mariandrasana twist, opening your shoulders and your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Place the soles of your feet on the mat. Arms are out on either side. Inhale first. Exhale, inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth. Take your block in hand, place your heels just below your sit bones. Inhale as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second or third levels, wherever you are is perfect. Maybe walk your feet forward, draw your arms overhead in a T formation or a mushroom formation if this is in your practice. Again, opening that lower back region even more. Draw those arms back overhead, walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up. Release the block and exhale down. Good job. And then from here, we're going to do legs straight up, allowing the circulation to come back down to our vital organs and our brains. Or push your hips up, walk your shoulders under in a shoulder stand. Again, feet are in Barbie feet, looking like a candlestick. Possibly draw those toes overhead, but be gentle with yourselves in halasana or plow pose. Maybe bend your knees, placing them around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra coming down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug, rock back and forth. Good job. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out, inhale. One more time, inhale. Cross that right leg over left, wrap your feet, arms are out east and west, inhale first. Exhale as your knees fall to the left, look over your right shoulder in a full body twist. Inhale back to center. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Cross that left leg over right, wrap your feet, arms are out east and west. Inhale first, exhale down to the right again in a full body twist. Inhale back to center, unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out, inhale. One more time, inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso, palms are up to receive, down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms,
Come back to a seated position, facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are in Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Monday. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you tomorrow. I won't see you for the rest of the week, though, but I do look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste. And I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong to end practice. So great to see everyone. I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording.